meet the man who works in a place where just about everything can kill you.
I'm a mountain guide, expedition leader, and I lead people up the highest mountains in the world.
Garrett Madison owns Madison Mountaineering, which specializes in guiding amateur adventure seekers up several of the world's most treacherous peaks. Garrett leads about 10 expeditions a year, taking care of every detail from planning routes to rationing food and supplies.
Step and rest.
It's his job to lead his clients on their climbs and keep them safe from Mother Nature's wrath.
There's avalanches, icefall, rockfall, crevasses, altitude illness potential. So all of these things make it very dangerous.
Much of his business is done here on Mount Everest, where Garrett takes up to a dozen clients a year.
For me on Everest, the first time was incredible getting to the top. But now coming back, I enjoy helping other climbers realize their goal. It's a bucket list type thing, something they've dreamed about for years and decades, maybe their whole life.
But on the world's tallest peak, an exhilarating hike can turn into a deadly tragedy in no time.
Marissa Eve Girawong was one of the first Americans reported dead after a massive earthquake caused an avalanche.
In 2015, 22 people died in a catastrophic avalanche at Everest Base Camp, including Garrett's girlfriend and team doctor, Eve Girawong.
Losing Eve was very hard for everybody, obviously, her family, her friends, myself. And I thought, gosh, is this really something I should be doing with my life? Should I continue climbing?
After some serious soul searching, Garrett ultimately returned to work.
I didn't want to walk away from the mountain or quit on such a low note.
There's Everest.
When I'm helping other climbers get to the top,
you got it.
I can feel their excitement, their joy, like I've had this amazing positive contribution onto their lives.
Garrett has now taken more climbers to the top of Everest than any other guide. And despite the ever-present dangers, business is good.
A good year, everything goes smooth, I could make about six figures. If I have a bad year and lose equipment like I have several times and various natural disasters, I could lose a lot.
There's no reason to cut corners. This could be life or death.